Hey guys, what's going on? Tricky Mess here, and we're back for the second team in the AL Central today. Going with the Twins. Got some, actually, two really high numbers here, and Miguel Sano is going to be the number one seed, and Dozier is going to be the number two seed. And then it looks like Kenny's Vargas is going to be the three, and Max Kepler is going to be the four. Is there anything higher than 52? Nope. Okay, we'll go Buxton as the 5, Rosario as the 6, Castro as the 7. What's 51? So yeah, I guess it's Eduardo Escobar. Oh, no, it's not. 47. Did I just see 48? Who is. Okay, I've confused myself. Jason Castro is the 7 at 51. So 48's next. Robbie Grossman. All right, that's right. We're ready to go. Target. And okay, we're ready to go. Did Dozier really have 42 home runs last year? That doesn't seem right at all. Okay, I didn't know that. Well, we're gonna get right into it. I believe Robbie Grossman will be first.
Welcome to the Home Run Derby. Let's
Yep,
get right to it.
and we're
It's
gonna
time
get right into
for
it.
the Home Run Derby. Hitting first, representing your Minnesota Twins, number 36, Robbie Grossman.
Nope, and nope. Twins are one of those teams that I don't know a whole lot about, but it's hard not to root for them because of past history with their poor success. But yeah, I think this is gonna be a good one with Dozier and Sano. But Grossman hasn't hit one yet. A minute in, he's got
Three
nada.
minutes to go.
There's his first note. There's high walls out there. This is a hard home run park. That's one though.
There's
Score
home run
36.
number one.
A minute and 20 seconds in, he gets his first one. And like, I don't know a lot about Minnesota. I wish I did. I don't mind them. I'll root for them. I've seen them play live before in Detroit when I went. That's who they were playing, and they lost like 20-3. But Grossman's having all sorts of issues to
Two
start those
minutes
off.
remaining.
Is that gonna stay? Nope. Oh my god. Well, I think Miguel Sano's safe. Is Grossman not find his groove? That's gonna hit foul. Target Field is a really nice stadium. I like how you can see the city out of right field. It also just has a cool look with the Minnesota thing up
One
in center
minute remaining.
field. There's a homer.
Number two.
He's at two. That's gonna hook foul. What team did we do from the AL Central last time? Kansas
30
City.
seconds left.
Yeah, they're probably the least hard-hitting team in the division. I thought it would be Minnesota, but I did not know Dozier. hit that many home runs last year. I knew Sano was going to be up there in power.
Another home run.
He is at 3. Let's see if he can get one more. Nope.
No time remaining.
He finishes with three
home runs. And he'll have to wait and see if that's
enough. My notes. All right.
Hitting
there
second.
You go. There's
McCullin,
Miguel Sano.
Representing your Minnesota Twins, number 22, Miguel
pulls a foul.
Sano.
That's a high one.
A very long home run.
Nope, pulls a foul. This is going to be a quick round. Number two.
That one is Tom. His second home run. That's number three. Three minutes to go.
Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. I'm sorry guys, I'm really tired today. This is the first video I'm recording today. I have band concert later and that one's going high.
There's
everyone to end
it.
Going
to be the one that does it. That ends the round. He finishes with a total of
471.
And that means he'll be moving on to the semifinal match.
Let's check how the Royals did. AL Central. 471 would not get on the board. Low is Gordon with a 480. 471 is along for Sano. Now we get to Byron Buxton.
Up first in this head-to-head matchup, representing your Minnesota Twins, number 25, Byron Buxton.
There's the first one. 414 off of.
That's his first home run.
Buxton is facing Max Kepler. And I think there's number, no, just short. Why are my dogs barking? Why do they always bark in my videos? Why can't Byron Buxton get a home run? I really like Byron Buxton.
3 minutes.
Remember
to
the
go.
Day he first came up, all the MLB Network guys were going crazy. I think he went like, I don't remember if he did good or not. There's a long
run.
One, 445. I know he stole a base. I do remember that. There's another
there
long one, 404. Now I'm talking really fast.
A hat trick. Three in a row.
And if Buxton gets home run, he's gonna have the most home run so far. And there it is. 453, there's the 30-second bonus. Just short.
2 minutes remaining.
Can of corn. 453 is Buxton's long.
There it is.
He's one off a batter's eye. That foul. That's going back, back.
There's
yes.
Number seven.
That's looking good. That wall out on the right is really high.
There's number eight. 1 minute remaining.
Nope. Oh boy. Buxton is slowing down a bit until right there. That one's
home
gone. 412.
I think
almost all
left.
Of this has been over 400 feet. He's putting up some good numbers here in the first round. There's a good chance of holding off Kepler. That's going to go for
number 10.
As long as still a 453, I think. Yeah. And this is the last swing before bonus rounds. Oh my god, I'm losing my voice too. And close swing of bonus doesn't go as planned. But the second one does. Maybe. Okay, it goes more as planned. Not perfect. There's something good.
There's
two opposite
11.
Field. He's going to get one more swing in. And it's going to go foul. He might get one more.
Time's up.
No, he's not.
So that will do it. He
so
finishes with 11.
Buxton's
line
was a 453.
And have to hope that's
he finishes
to
with 10. Or no, 11.
The clock is running and the round has begun.
He's number one for Catrell in the first swing.
Representing your Minnesota Twins, number 26, Max Kepler.
Yeah, 439. Oh my god. Kepler's off to a good start. That one goes foul. That's not gonna go. That one's tanked. 476. Max Kepler's off to a great start. A very, very great start. Oh, is that gonna stay? No, not even close. That's a high one. He's gonna make it. 399. And he has almost already caught up to Buxton. That's not
going
to go. That one
home
is 387.
Seven
43, there's a 30-second bonus. Thought he already earned that. He might have.
404,
he's only three away from Buxton. That gonna go Oppo into the bullpen? Yeah, it is.
So
I think it's a 476, if I don't. Ooh, I think it's a 476. Yeah, it's a 476, I just saw it on the board. 396, he's one away.
30 seconds left.
And it's tied now, and that one's gone. 488. And if Kepler hits one more home run, which you can only assume he is, Alex Gordon from the Royals will be eliminated from this competition.
And
8 feet longer.
That ends the
488
run.
For Kepler.
The run with a total of 12 home runs. And he has earned a trip to the semifinal matchup.
All right. Our first semis matchup is set. We got Miguel Sano and Max Kepler. But first, we're going to have Eddie Rosario against Kenny Vargas.
Now hitting. Representing your Minnesota Twins, number 20, Eddie Rosario.
Rosario's going 453 dead center
a
to start.
Very long home run.
Oh boy.
His second home run.
Rosario came to play. That one's not so much. Down the line. Oh boy.
That's number
15.
Three.
.465, there's the bonus.
3 minutes to go.
Oh, that's just so short. Rosario's off to a great start. Slowing down a little now, though. Opposite field into the bullpen just short. That's not though.
That's
414.
Number five.
Oh boy.
That
460.
One is
that went all the way up off that scoreboard up
Two
there.
Remaining.
That's gonna go. 465 is still as long. But he's putting up some great numbers right now. That's not gonna make it. Good chance to upset Vargas. 440. What did that hit? What is that thing?
Home run
414.
Nine.
He's just murdering the ball. Nope.
1 minute remaining.
That's not going to do it. He's at 9 with 48 seconds plus the bonus. And that one is gone. He is just putting up some insane numbers right now. Number 11, same spot as the last one.
Now 11 home runs for him. A hat trick.
425. And so I have some more disappointing news about that Giants one, besides how bad I did. Here comes the bonus time, but the guy who won for the Giants, Michael Morse, is currently batting 167 and has one homer in the real life this year. So video game him is much better than actual him. He was a Pirate for a little bit and didn't do so well. Last swing for Rosario.
No time
nope,
remaining.
It goes short, that but he finishes with 13.
He finishes with 13 home runs.
And Kenny's Vargas now.
See if that holds up. Let's see what he can do.
Now it's sky high. Is that going to go? Yeah, it is. 426. Oh, is that going to stay fair? No, it hooks just foul. Letting it get deep, going oppo. Nope. There's one though.
Number
36.
Two.
Crap, I didn't look at the long for Rosario. I think it was a 467.
There it
378.
Is. Third home run. 3 minutes to go.
Oh boy, 455. That was way up there. That's his long so far. Opposite field down the line. Now it's gonna hook foul. That's not hooking foul. 452. There's the 30-second bonus, and this is gonna be a close round.
That's gone.
Not a home run, is it? I don't know. I counted. Oh boy, that's going far. 426. Pulls that one foul.
2 minutes remaining.
Halfway there, and Vargas is looking good. And he's fouls off two in a row. That one's not foul though.
Home run number 8.
5 away. 4 away. I thought Rosario had Vargas. Vargas gained a swing, though. And that one's cranked.
Never any question about that one.
That's the second time something's hit that strange black thing out there.
1 minute remaining.
Number 38, he's two away from the tie. And his long is only a 455. Slowing down a little.
30 seconds
left. Oh boy. He's got 30 seconds plus the bonus and he needs 3 to move on. 10 seconds. There's, ooh, no, he's gonna get one more swing in the round. He's gonna make it count. 460, there's his new long. He needs two in bonus. That's sky high, but is it gonna make it out? No. 10 seconds off the clock. But there's one. That one's cranked. 411. Needs one more. It's tied. And he does it. 460 is Vargas's long.
He ends the round with a total of 14 home runs. And that means
that was a great round.
The semifinal matchup.
Now, oh wow, there's only one offensive field homer. Now we move on to Jason Castro against Ryan Dozier. And Castro's gonna
hitting
come
first,
up right now.
Representing your Minnesota Twins, number 21,
and
he ain't
going foul.
Castro. That one is five. His second home run. Three minutes to go.
Well, it's far. 469. I thought we were road. Is that thing over there? Is that part of the stadium, the glass? I mean, I know it's part of the stadium, but is it like clubs? I don't know. Yeah, that has to be clubs or a restaurant or something. He has 2 minutes in. Now they make that four. 453. He's cranking the ball. Along of 469. Opposite field. Yes. A little. Oh, no. He's just pushing the ball. Asher is putting up a good fight here. That's the second one in a row for the bullpen. And the pitch and going foul.
1 minute remaining.
Right down the line. He's going off of a lot now. Thirty seconds left.
That one
That's
is gone.
420 feet. He's at 9. He needs to get into the bonus and put up a few decent ones here. And here comes the bonus time right now. And he's getting a good start. .375. He needs one more.
Now 11 home runs for him.
And well, he doesn't need one more. Oh, he's gonna get one more pitch. And he's gonna make it count.
Another home run.
So I believe
up.
What
so
was it?
It? He ends the run with a total of 12 home
69.
Runs. And he'll have to wait and see if that's enough.
Well, let's see if Dozier can get 13
let's see
first.
What he can do. And now the challenger. Representing
I think
Minnesota
it's gonna
twins,
make it.
Number two,
yeah, that's a good start
Ryan
right there, right into the
Dozier.
Bullpen. That is top row, 474.
three in a row now.
Oh boy, Dozier. Off to a great start. Oh, that one's nice. Is it staying fair? No. That was really close. That one's staying fair. 465.
That's 15.
And he's... He's rolling here. Doing exactly what we'd expect him to do. Right down the line. I think that's going to hook just foul. That's just a pop up. And he's slowing down a little. Never mind.
Home run number
89.
2 minutes remaining.
Or 49. No, just short. Needs five more. He has the bonus. Long of a 489. And there's another long one.
That clears the wall.
He's just hooking on the foul.
1 minute remaining.
Needs four more to tie. Make that three more.
Home run number 9.
Two more.
10 home runs now.
See if he can end it before the round's over.
30 seconds left. His third in a row.
He needs one more to tie. Hooks a foul.
Another home run.
481. There's another long one. Dozier can end it right here, and he doesn't. He's going to need bonus time. Just needs one, though. Just hooks foul. And that's going to end it. 489 long.
And
never
that
mind.
Is gonna do it. That ends the round. He finishes with 13 home runs.
Holy crap.
And he has earned a trip to the semifinal matchup.
Welp. That was a long one. Dozier hits 530.
The semifinal matchup is now underway. Up first in the semifinal.
And Max Kepler starting us off with a long one in the second round.
Kepler.
And then he just has two pop-ups right after.
There's 445.
Okay, Kepler's starting to get into it a little.
3 minutes to go.
There's another one. But it's going to go just short. That one's not going short. That's going to make it out.
Out of here. That's his fourth home run.
He still needs one more long one to break, though. Bonus time. I think that's going to do it.
It's
473.
He has earned an additional
as long as a 488,
time.
Though. Get that one into the little weird section.
There's
461. Kepler's starting to get some long ones. Watch out, Miguel Sano. There's another one. 489. That's his new long. Dozier hit 530. That one's going back. And that's 455. And there's number 10. Right into the little weird section again. Oh, just hook and foul. That's going far. 469.
About that one. Oh, that
440.
30 seconds left.
No hook foul. And
that
473. He is at 14, and he still has the bonus. 15 going into the bonus.
Hat trick. Three in a row.
Miguel Sano is going to have to go from hitting four in the first round to possibly 18 here in the second. And no, he's only going to have to hit 17 in the second.
He finishes with a total of 16 home runs, and you'll have to hope that's enough to advance. The clock has
Sano's
officially
giving
started.
Start and going short. That's not the start he needed. And Sano hits two, not over. There's his first one.
Gone. That's his first home run.
And as long as a 471, there's a 447. There's a 468.
He has earned bonus time.
He's earned the bonus.
That's number four in a row. Three minutes to go.
Hooks foul. That's not gonna make it either. But that one is.
That's number five.
Opposite field. He's gonna start needing to put up some numbers here. And that he does.
Home run number
26.
Six. His
oh
third
boy.
Consecutive home run.
Here comes the no. Hooks a foul.
Gonna
hook
remaining.
Two.
No,
467 right into the upper deck.
Home run
81. That's his new long. That's gonna make it two at a 447 mark dead center field. That's gonna stay there and hit the foul pole, another 481.
That is five in a row.
He needs four more. Make that four.
Six.
I thought Kepler had it. Needs two more. That's right, another one right into that little weird section. And Sano could finish this without bonus time. And he can't. He's gonna need bonus time. But Miguel Sano hits four in the first round and 17 in the second.
That ends the round.
And we're going to go to the next round with Dozier and Vargas. But I'm going to need to make a cut right here. I completely forgot to do something. I'm gonna go take care of it right now. We're gonna stay right here. It'll be 2 seconds for you, it might be 10 minutes for me. So, I'm gonna make a cut right here, and we'll get right into the round. Alright, cut over. We're going right into it, Kenny
Up
Vargas.
first in this semifinal matchup, number 19, Kenny's
And he's starting
Vargas.
off with a long foul ball. And he's starting off with two long foul balls. And is that gonna stay? No. Oh boy, Vargas is struggling. Is he able to push that one over? No, it's not gonna make it off the base of the wall. And he is off to a rough start. Brian Dozier might have it easy here, but
3 minutes
that
to
can be the
go.
start of something right there at
There's home run
4.3.
number one.
As long as a 460. It's going into the. Oh no, just off the front of the wall. He has one. Oh boy, Vargas is really struggling. I think that's gonna go though.
That's a
Barely
home run.
370 down the left field line. And that looks more like Kenny Vargas.
A very
460.
long home run.
The highs is long.
It's
453,
gone.
there's the
He
bonus.
has earned an additional bonus time. 2 minutes remaining.
That's dead center. That's gonna go. Oh no, it's not. It's gonna hook just foul. That's gonna be a long one.
That's a home run.
452.
Fifth in the run. Another home run.
426. See, the scary thing about the AL Central.
That's three
I
in a
don't
row.
know if Dozier's 530 foot shot is guaranteed to hold. You have to think. You still have Edwin Encarnacion, Miguel
One
Cabrera,
minute
Victor
remaining.
Martinez. I'm missing a team in this division. Jose Abreu, Todd Frazier,
Another home run.
all in this one division. feet could be
30
touched
seconds
more
left.
than three times. Mean, I don't think anyone's gonna touch Arenado's 553 for the
Home
longest.
run number nine.
But Vargas is really turning it around here. That's another dead center.
Make it 10 home
He's
runs
at
now.
10. Last one of the round before bonus. And going into bonus, he's at 10. 11.
There's a home run.
He's keeping it inside 460, but he's getting a decent amount. That's going into the bullpen.
There's number 12 now.
He's gonna get one, maybe two more swings. And is he gonna make them count? That's
His
gone. Is he
third
gonna get another
consecutive
swing?
home
No.
run.
He's gonna end at
Time's up.
13.
So that will
Long
be,
is
he
still
finishes with
460.
13 home runs. And you'll have to wait and see if that holds
And
up.
he looks happy about it, doesn't he? But that might not be enough for Dozier. He has to get
Let's start the
14
clock.
here.
Now hitting the challenger in this
And
semifinal
there's
matchup,
one.
Ryan Dozier.
One like by accident. And there's number two.
No doubt
He's
about that
already
one.
earned the bonus.
That one is gone. He
Dozier is off to a ridiculous start in this home run derby for the Twins. He's looked the best out of anyone, I think. But he's starting to hook a few foul. Starting to hook a lot foul. It's not going to stay. Yes, it is. 470. He hooks another one. Didn't hook that one. 455. He's at six halfway through.
2 minutes remaining.
There's number seven. 479. Dozier's just killing him. I think Dozier's had three longer than Vargas is long. And did not mean to take that pitch. Hook and foul again. Dozier's starting gonna have to start putting up some good numbers here. Hook and foul again. He has a minute left to get six. Oh boy.
1 minute remaining.
And now Dozier's struggling. Oh no. There's one.
There's number eight.
He hooks it foul again. He might get three more swings here. Hooks it foul again. And this could be the end of Dozier. Just the inability to keep them fair. He's going to need four here in bonus. And Brian Dozier is dead in the water. He's not going to go on. Kenny's Vargas has upset Brian Dozier. Oh my goodness, he just hits a 495-foot home run. And 13-10, Kenny's Vargas is moving on to the finals against Miguel Sano.
Won't be enough to advance. Unfortunately, he has been eliminated. Let's see what he can
and
do.
Here goes Vargas' first at bat in the finals. And there's number one.
There's home run number one.
And he's still at one. That one's going a long way. That could be his new long. Nope, only 440.
It's 454. Gone. He has earned an additional bonus time.
That's off the back wall at 434. And Kenny Vargas is putting on a show here. Cannot break 460 though, so if he loses, he's out. Unlike Dozier, who still has a pretty good chance of moving on with the long of 530.
2 minutes remaining.
He's at six, halfway through, and he has the bonus.
Seven home runs.
One opposite field, 369. And that's going in the gap.
Another
452.
Yes,
right off the foul pole, 385.
1 minute remaining.
he's starting to slow down. He's only at 9. 35 seconds left in the round. It's another ground ball. Going opposite field, just short. That's not just short. 99. He's at 10. He's at 11, going into the bonus. And the first bonus hit is right down the line. Opposite field, nope, just short. He's gonna get two more swings. He's gonna make
There's
that one count.
Now. That ends the
Looks
run.
At just foul.
He ends
with
12.
So now he's 13.
And
there's
and
number one.
448. Number 22, Miguel Sano.
Number two is a 414.
That's
392. He's off to a hot start. He's already a quarter of the way there. Oh my god, Miguel Sano is a layman right now. 470. What is Sano's long? 31.
3 minutes to go.
He has 3 minutes left. He's already at 5. Make that. Oh no, that looked a lot better than it actually was. That one's gone.
That one is gone. He has earned
Sano's halfway there. That's gonna make
seven
it over.
Home runs now.
He said 7. He's at 8. Already not even halfway through the round, and he still has bonus. Dead center, 452.
2 minutes remaining.
So no.
Consecutive home
looks
run.
To be the championship, the champion for the new, what am I saying? He
That's
looks to be the champion
run.
For the Minnesota Twins. I almost said New York Yankees. That was 2 episodes ago. 400 right off the foul pole to tie it. And Miguel Sano wins the Twins. 466. As long as a 481.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Home Run Derby champion, Miguel Sano.
Miguel Sano. All right, well, this is going to be the episode, guys. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys later. Bye.